Ready? Ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Ford Show. Starring Tennessee Ernie Ford, Ernie Ford, Ernie Ford, Ernie Ford, Ernie Ford, Ernie Ford.
This has been a recorded announcement.
Sure as a star, wherever we are, it's together.
Wherever I go, I know they go.
Wherever he goes, we know we go. No fits, no fights, no feuds, and no egos.
Amigos.
Together.
Through thick and through thin, ooh, all out or all in. Ooh. And whether it's win, place, or show. With you for me,
and me for you,
we'll muddle through whatever we do together,
wherever we go.
In every other song that I've heard lately, some fella gets shot, and his baby and his best friend both die with him, as likely as not. In half the other songs, some kids are crying, all ready to die. We've lost most all of our happy people, and I'm a wondering why. Let's think about living. Let's think about loving.
Think about loving.
Let's think about the hooping and the hopping and the bopping and the lovey-lovey-dovin.
Lovey-lovey-dovin.
Let's forget about the whining and the crying and the shooting and the dying and the fella with the switchblade knife. Let's think about living.
Think about living.
Let's think about life. Yeah, here they are. Well, we lost old Marty Robbins down in El Paso a while back. And now Miss Patty Page, or one of them, is going to be wearing black. Kathy's clown has Don and Phil where they feel like they could die. If we keep losing our singers like that, I'll be the only one you can buy.
Let's think about living.
Let's think about living.
Let's think about loving.
Let's think about loving. Let's think about the hooping and the hopping and the bopping and the lovey-lovey-loving. Let's forget about the whining and the crying and the shooting and the dying and the fellow with the switchblade knife. Let's think about living.
Think about living.
Let's think about life.
Let's think about life.
Let's think about living. About love. About love.
Much. Thank you. Yeah, I'm glad everybody's back. Everybody all right?
Yep. Huh? Yeah.
Fine? Up in the buggy?
Yeah.
Hubba hubba. See you in a minute.
Hubba.
Bye. There they go.
That's the greatest bunch in the whole wide world. Hello there. And join us for our fifth. I'm not going to put that different, but for our fifth year. We're very glad to be back, and we hope we're still welcome sitting there in your house, and we thank you folks for coming by to see us. I hope you all had as restful a summer as I did. Betty and I and all the kids, we went back to Hawaii, and we certainly thank them for being so nice to us over there. Oh, Hawaii, the land of luaus and hulas and
grass skirts. You know, I was brought up on a farm, but I have never seen hay pitched like that before in all my life. Sight to see. But you know, we had a great time, but I no sooner than got back home, picked up the newspaper. My goodness, this world's in a mess. Look what's happened since I've been gone. Trouble everywhere. Cuba. The Congo. And the Los Angeles Coliseum. We sure made a swap, didn't we? Pittsburgh sent us their smog. We sent them our pennant. Oh, you're here today. Well, welcome, Pennsylvanians, my goodness. But things are looking up, I tell you true, because I am happy to bring you the first bright spot I have seen since all this trouble started. Here he is, not only mine, but everybody's little bitty buddy, George Gobel!
Hi there, big buddy, with the remains of a brush fire under your nose.
Hello there, little bitty buddy with the freshly mowed head.
Well, I'll tell you the reason for that. I'm going to be on wagon train October 5th, and I thought I'd save them the trouble of scalping me.
Oh, well, you look great. Did you have a good summer?
Well, Ern, I'll tell you the truth. I did something this summer that I've been wanting to do all my life. I packed Alice and the kids and all the luggage in our station wagon and headed it right straight for Vancouver.
Oh, the whole family. That's great.
Yeah. Then I went to Las Vegas and had a ball.
Well, I hooked
it up.
You didn't.
I'll tell you, actually, I was working there, see.
Oh, I see.
At one of the big hotels.
Yeah, well, I'm so glad you're back, and I tell you, it just warms my old black heart to know that you'd just take time to come by and help us start out our new season.
Well, Ern, after all, really, I'm flattered about it, because here you've chosen little old me when, for a lot less money, you could have gotten a presidential candidate.
You know, you're right. The past few weeks, those two fellas have been on television more than the reruns of Amos and Andy, you know?
They're easy to get. They were on Jack Parr and Face the Nation, Meet the Press, Open End, and... Oh, and I hear that right after the election, one of them is going to be on What's My Line?
One of those nights, they're going to open that door on the Loretta Young show, and those two are going to come waltzing through.
I just wonder which one of them is going to be leading.
Yeah.
We'll fight about that. But the big excitement hasn't even started yet, Ern. You know, next Monday, on every television network, for the first time in history, two presidential candidates will be debating face to face.
No.
Don't you realize that?
Well, you know I'm for that.
Sure.
I say bring the important issues right out in front of the friends and neighbors.
Yeah, well, I'm with you there, but I think these presidential debates are fine, except if they become a regular thing on television, need I tell you what could happen in the future?
I think you're trying to tell me something.
I'm trying to get a message through.
Well, it's coming through.
Is it?
Yeah. I can see what you mean. Now, television shows are mighty expensive.
Right. Huh?
So they'll eventually have to have sponsors to pay. Then they're going to have rating troubles. Well, then pretty soon they'll have to go into competition with other commercial television shows as entertainment.
You know, outside of a few little grammatical errors there, you took the words right out of my mouth.
You know, I can look ahead and see what a presidential debate in 1968 might be like.
Yeah,
sort of a two-man political spectacular, you know, with all of that stuff.
Now, wait just a minute, Ern. Ern, instead of telling your vast gingham and seersucker audience, why don't we just take advantage of this electronic cartoon box here and show them?
Well, now, I'm for that.
Sure you are.
But first, before you folks...
Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly bring you the 1968 presidential debate, sponsored by Sudsy Soap Products, and starring your two laughable, lovable candidates, Governor George Goebel and Senator Ernie Ford. And to open the show, here are the Sudsy Detergent Dancing Darlings.
Get it turned on, I just can't turn it off that quick.
Well, I know. This is our political debate.
That's right, and it's nice to see you here.
Good evening, friends. Good evening to all of you, friends.
Yes,
and how are you, Governor?
Fine, Senator. Suppose we ought to get our
podium, and we'll get things to going right away.
Because I don't make a move without my podium.
Me neither. I wouldn't dare. Now, shall we make our opening statements, Governor?
All righty, Senator.
You right here.
Double your income, triple your tax, and double good Goebel will spend your greenbacks. Double your votes, vote for me twice. It may not be legal, but it would be nice.
I love labor in the springtime. I love voters in the fall. I have campaigned in the summer when it sizzles. Send me to the White House by the winter before it drizzles. From the land of sky blue waters. Comes to candidates refreshing
water.
Very well done. And now let's get down to some serious political issues.
Yes, sir. That's why we're here. Now, Senator, how do you feel about foreign aid?
I'm for it.
Good.
I think it's about time some of these foreign countries helped us out a little bit.
Pretty funny line. Where'd you get that?
That's my new writer, Thank you, Adelaide. Now, how about your stand on Cuba?
Well, let me tell you about that one time. We were doing a pretty good thing with it. We were doing pretty good with it, selling bananas on a stick and postcards, but those Castros, they confiscated it like everything else.
Yeah.
Now, I wrote a strong letter to old Fidel, but all I got back was his New York hotel bill and a sack full of chicken feathers. That ain't right.
You didn't.
Yes, I did. Now, speaking of this particular problem, Senator,
yeah,
what do you think should be done about Red China?
I am glad you asked me that.
Are you?
Ladies, if you have Red China or any other color china, it should be washed in Sudsy soap flakes. Governor? And for your bath, ladies, be sure to get a bar of Sudsy pink soap. Sudsy pink soap does not lather, bubble, or float. It's just good company in the tub.
Right. And remember, wherever politicians gather, it's Sudsy soap for a clean caucus.
What?
To our controversial debate.
I think we better, Governor. Right. Now, I mentioned my record in Washington. Would you like to mention your record in Washington?
I'm glad you asked me about my record in Washington, because I want my record held right up to the public eye.
Bring it forth.
Will you bring out my record, please? Thank you. Now, this is my latest record, and it's called Political Speeches to Dance By. I think you're going to like it. There are three selections in here on each side, including such toe-tapping favorites as the Monroe Doctrine, Cha-Cha-Cha, the Lumumbo Mambo, background music by the Red Army Choir singing Bongo, 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 I Don't Want to Leave the Congo. And last but not least, a sentimental favorite, When I Grow Too Old to Dream, Will I Have Medical Care to Remember? Waltz. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Big Jim.
Big Jim?
It's my campaign manager.
You must make a lot of whistle stops.
I mean, come on. You know, with a campaign manager like that, it doesn't make any difference whether you win or lose.
It's just how you've played the game.
That's all right. I'm a player and a goer. Now, Senator, about the cost of living, it is the belief of my great political party...
Just a minute, Governor. You can't mention your political party on television.
It's dirty?
No, no. No, it means that the sponsor sells the product to both parties, you see.
They're both dirty.
No, no. It's just that they don't want to offend anybody.
Oh,
you know,
I
you're
see.
On TV.
Somebody has to decide things.
You
like
have
that.
To make
you
a decision.
You have to make big decisions.
You have to make decisions.
Especially in our business. We got to make momentous decisions.
If you believe that and you like to make decisions,
I like to make
tell
decisions.
Me which bundle of laundry was washed in Sudsy soap place.
That's a tough one. To start out with,
You take your time, Senator. Take your time. Governor, take your time.
Well, see, I don't want to make a quick decision here. My whole political career could depend on this decision right here.
I understand.
Well, tell you what, I think... I think this one feels softer, but this one smells better.
Governor, you have got to make a decision and pinpoint that decision. We are waiting.
Ibbity bibbity zibbity. Ibbity bibbity canabble. I say this one.
Here
I
am, sir. Absolutely right, Governor. This one was washed in sudsy, and this one was washed in dirt. I think now...
Pick up some sudsy at your nearest market. Remember, it's kind to what's left of your hands.
Absolutely. I think we can get on with our closing statements. Are you ready, Governor?
I am ready, sir.
Ready?
hardly wait.
The country's in the very best of hands, the best of hands,
the best of hands.
Tell them, Governor.
The Treasury says the national debt is climbing to the sky.
Oh, oh.
The government expenditures have never been so high.
Tired of hawks, man. Terrible.
It makes a fella get a gleam of pride within his eye to see
how our economy expands. The country's in the very best of hands.
Now it's your turn, Senator. Give him a filibuster.
All right.
You ought to hear the Senate when they're drawing up a bill.
That's terrible, isn't it?
Where asses and two wits are crowded in each codicil.
Codicil?
That dirty?
Since legal terminology would give your heart a thrill. There's phrases there that no one understands. The country's in the very best of hands. The country's in the very best of hands.
We hope that once again you will enjoy our moments of inspiration that we'll bring you throughout the coming year.
Let there be pig and heart.